Fun Radio.
Enjoy the music.
Merci à vous d'écouter Fun Radio et on reçoit maintenant un nouvel artiste qu'on aime beaucoup chez Fun et ça tombe bien parce qu'il va venir mixer dans quelques jours maintenant à Fun Radio Ibiza Experience. Il s'appelle Steve Aoki. Bienvenue ici dans notre studio Fun Radio à Tomorrowland Winter. Steve, est-ce que tu kiffes le ski, les montagnes ou t'es plutôt plage et Miami?
Well, welcome to our studio in Tomorrowland Winter in RDS. Do you prefer, are you more beach and Miami person or more mountain ski person?
Well, you know, I was born in Miami, and I grew up in Southern California, so I'm surrounded by water. I love the water, but I love snowboarding in the snow. So I have to go 50-50 because I love both.
Il est effectivement partagé. Bon, on va parler aussi de ta musique, Steve Aoki. Tu as une collab en ce moment qui est entrée dans la playlist de Fun Radio avec les Galantis, Angry Heart. Comment vous avez eu l'idée de ce morceau avec ce duo suédois, les Galantis?
How did you come up with the idea of this duo with Galantis, Hungry Heart?
Well, I had this idea with Haley, Kyoko, and we were on it for a while, actually. And I wanted to add Galantis to it. I was, you know, listening to my version of the production, and I'm like, we need this, like, different sound I want to integrate. And I was like, I've always wanted to work with Galantis and do a song with them. And big fans of their production, love them as people. Sent them what I was working on. He loved it. And then he really twisted it up and put his Galantis DNA all over it. And it was a perfect medium between, like, the Steve Aoki production, Galantis production, and this amazing vocalist and singer-songwriter, Haley Kyoko.
Et ce morceau, vous pouvez l'écouter évidemment dans la playlist toute la journée sur Fun Radio. Justine.
Dans un peu plus d'un mois, on se retrouvera à l'Accor Arena pour Fun Radio Ibiza Experience. Ça fait hyper longtemps que tu n'es pas venue en France. Qu'est-ce que tu gardes comme souvenir de notre pays?
Well, soon you'll be in the Accor Arena for the Fun Radio Ibiza Experience. It's been a while since you've had a set in France. What kind of memory do you keep of our country?
Well, I've had a long memory of France because, you know, when I first got into, when I first got bigger as a DJ, there was Ed Banger and Pedro Busy P. He was a kind of my gateway into France. So when I came to Paris, I would play Social Club with DJ Mehdi and Busy P. And, you know, Justice would be there. I don't think they were playing, but because they were too big.
Not Daft Punk.
not Daft Punk. But Tomas played in my club.
Ah, ça c'est important. Where?
And at the Denmark party at Cinespace in LA.
Okay.
Because we had a this ongoing relationship that Ed Banger would come to LA, they'd come to the Denmark party. So it'd be a Denmark Ed Banger party. And then when I come to France, they would host a party and I would play with Sebastian and Kavinsky and, you know, Mehdi and Pedro, and so then, like, we had a really insane LA party, and Tomas was there, he was DJing, you know, with his Ed Banger headphones, and no one really knew it was the guy from Daft Punk, because the party's so small and intimate, you know. Yeah. We had some legendary nights, so
long time ago.
I really, like, when I think about France and the parties I've played, I think about these like the earlier period of time. Like, I remember when I played with Sebastian, he played this sample of this French politician that got caught, like, doing drugs or cheating or something. And he looped him saying, like, I'm sorry, I fucked this girl or whatever. I forgot what he said. It's embarrassing him, like, you know, like an embarrassing thing. And he looped it for like 10 minutes. And he just played the sample. it was like an art show. You know, it was like a performative art experience.
Great memories.
Yeah, it's just like those kinds of moments you don't forget. Uffy was always playing there too. So yeah, it's just that era of time was a very special time.
Parfait. Et alors, parce qu'on on t'attend ici à Fun Radio Ibiza Experience. Pour ceux qui ne t'ont jamais vu mixer, un show de Steve Aoki, c'est quoi? Il faut savoir que quand on a annoncé ton nom et ta venue à Paris, ça a été incroyable au niveau de la billetterie.
For those who never saw a Steve Aoki show, what is it? You have to know that when they opened the ticket sale, when they announced your name, it was mad.
Yeah?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
In Paris.
People are excited?
Yes. Very excited.
That's cool.
On peut lui dire qu'il a quasiment rempli l'Accor Arena à lui.
À lui-même.
Yeah, you feel the whole arena to yourself.
Oh my God. I'm so surprised. I just haven't played there in so long. I just don't know. You know, like, that's pretty amazing. I'm in shock and happy. Very grateful.
Du coup, on te prévoit combien de gâteaux à jeter?
How many cakes should we plan?
Oh, yeah. So, please follow my cake writer. Okay, I have a cake recipe.
Okay?
Because these cakes are not meant to be eaten. They're meant to be smashed in someone's face. And when they're the Steve Aoki cake, it's good. It's a explosive. It gets everywhere.
Ok.
It's all over the place.
Bon, et ben on va voir ça dans quelques jours. T'es un artiste au-delà de la musique qui t'intéresse vachement à la technologie, au futur. Pour toi, dans 5 à 10 ans, comment tu vois notre planète et surtout l'utilisation de la technologie? On voit que maintenant, il y a de plus en plus d'intelligence artificielle.
Well, you're an artist who is also very much focused on technology, future. For you, what will the planet be in 5 or 10 years? And what would be the place of AI?
Ooh. Well, yeah, with AI, the thing is, you can't get upset about it. It's like you can't stop it. Yeah. So you have to build on top of it. Because the big question for songwriters and producers is that AI is going to start writing music. And who knows what that looks like in 5 years? Who knows what, you know, like, also the consumption of music is changing because of social media. Like TikTok is a big platform on how to discover something that is not on the radio, right? And radio isn't the only source to find out about music. So when you think about these little jingles that you hear, because it's a jingle.
Yeah, it's 30 seconds.
It's a 15-second jingle. Yeah. Just like what we listened to 20 years ago in commercials, a 15-second jingle.
Yeah.
This is a new commercial that's free on TikTok, but these jingles are most likely going to get written by AI. You know, so now the question is, when we get to this stage, when AI is writing all the jingles, what does it look like for artists that are writers and producers in and trying to make money in the space? Will that be, you know, an issue for us, or will that make our music more valuable? So I think that's a big question right there. It's a very interesting question for specifically AI in music, right? But AI is going to be part of every process of how we communicate, socialize, date, buy, sell, economy, jobs, everything. So I think we have to think about it as a tool and not, you know, just like I remember, you know, in the 2000s when Serato came around and people were not DJing in vinyl anymore with vinyl records. The vinyl DJ, some vinyl DJ's like, no, I don't want to do this. No, please, this is horrible. Like, you're not a DJ. You're like, you know, you can't stop it. So you have to just use it to your advantage. You don't have to use it, but if you want to excel in that space, you need to be able to think about how to integrate it.
Justine, tu voulais poser justement une question, oui. Il en a parlé de TikTok à Steve Aoki.
Sur TikTok, tu as 2,8 millions d'abonnés. Alors pour moi, c'est un peu le nouveau SoundCloud, le nouveau MySpace. Est-ce que tu as déjà été inspiré par des vidéos TikTok ou est-ce que tu as découvert de nouveaux talents sur l'application?
Well, you've got more than 2.8 million followers on TikTok. Have you ever been inspired by some videos you found there?
So TikTok, I haven't done the rabbit hole. But I do think it's a powerful tool if you can train the algorithm for things that you think will help you, right? Because like TikTok is the best algorithmic platform out of all platforms, right? I'm an Instagram user, so I go down the Instagram hole, and the algorithm is a bit clunky. Now, I should go down TikTok. I've been thinking about it, and I'm like, okay, I need to come up with my five categories, and I need to train the algorithm. So every time I open it, boom, I get educated with, you know, the biohacking, you know, little thing, little tips here, or stuff on music, or whatever it is that I'm curious about. I haven't really gone down the rabbit hole yet.
Dans l'émission, on parle aussi beaucoup de gaming, de jeux vidéo. Tu as déjà fait des partenariats avec des jeux hein, comme dans Need for Speed No Limits, tu as relooké des voitures. C'est quoi ton jeu vidéo préféré? Est-ce que tu aimerais refaire des partenariats comme ça avec d'autres jeux?
Well, you had a partnership with some gaming, because the show talks a lot about gaming too. Okay. You already had a partnership with No Limits.
Need for Speed, merci.
where you've rebranded some cars.
Right.
Do you have any other partnership like this in mind or?
I mean, we're moving at an accelerator rate now. I'm doing all kinds of different partnerships in food and technology and gaming and sports and athletics. So it's just a lot. So it's hard for me to just pick one.
Do you play video games?
I'm a Call of Duty gamer.
Okay.
So I like to drop in the war zone, yeah. Like the battle royale, and try to not die.
C'est le plus difficile. J'ai vu que tu venais de faire une dédicace sur une chaussure de ski. C'est quoi l'endroit le plus improbable où tu as signé un autographe?
Well, you just signed an autograph on a ski boot. Where is the funniest or most awkward place you've ever left an autograph?
I guess body parts, I don't know. nothing below the belt. Yeah, I mean, maybe some like the top of an ass cheek.
C'est pas mal.
Probably, I don't know. It's very likely. I don't know.
C'est pas mal. Steve, merci beaucoup. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Pour venir ici dans notre studio Fun Radio. Et puis on te retrouve dans un peu plus d'un mois pour Fun Radio Ibiza Experience. La France, les Français t'attendent. French are waiting for you.
Amazing. I'm so happy.
Merci beaucoup, Steve.
Thank you. Merci beaucoup.
Merci beaucoup.